malt in Moray.
There we go. Well, thank you very much, Keith, for that introductory malt mention. Yes, my fellow malt mates, we are on location yet again as part of Ralphie's Grand Historic Tour 2011, which brings us to these individual, characterful, and, you know I do improve, independent distilleries, which happen to be dotted around Speyside, many of them. And you'll never guess where we are today. We are at Benromach in Speyside, just outside of, very close to Forres, and we're with Keith, who is distillery manager here, and Keith is going to tell us about where we are at the moment, because this isn't just an old Dunnage warehouse. This is a brand new Dunnage warehouse.
Hi, Ralph.
Hello.
Hello. We're actually in one of our new Dunnage warehouses at the moment. When we opened the distillery, we inherited one old traditional Dunnage warehouse. Mm-hmm. And obviously, because we were producing new stock, that warehouse filled pretty quickly within 2 or 3 years. This was back in 1998. So we had to obviously build another warehouse to hold the stocks of the future Benromach, which could be anything up to 10, 15 years. So we decided, we had to make a decision what kind of warehouse. Rack warehouse, palletized, quickly knew that we would have to build a traditional Dunnage warehouse with modern materials. We did this in 2001. So we built an earthen floored warehouse. Wooden rails, 2 or 3 high. We have stone wall blocks up to about 2.5 meters. Mm-hmm. And then we'll have it double insulated all the way around. So it was just to give us that same environment that you get in a traditional Dunnage warehouse. Nice, cool, cold, moist environment, just to slow down the maturation. And that's exactly what we wanted to do here. It cost us a lot of money, these warehouses. As you can see, we lose quite a bit of space here, just going 2 or 3 high. But this was the environment that we wanted to produce or to mature the whisky in. And really, that goes back to the whole way we make the whisky here at the distillery.
On that subject, you've mentioned the expense involved. Yep. In a Dunnage warehouse using modern materials. You've mentioned the insulation, you've mentioned the earth floors. Why go to the expense when you've got the far cheaper option of industrial and palletage?
The simple answer is, for us, was quality. That was the driving force right at the very start. It was always about the spirit quality, producing the highest quality new make spirit and then maturing it in the finest quality cask, but also the environment that we mature it in. And we feel, as is probably many other distillers, that the traditional Dunnage warehouse gives us that benefit of the quality of spirit, and that is the simple answer. It's just for quality of spirit.
And I certainly agree with you on that, and it's something that whisky fans are very much more informed about than used to be. But the warehouse is simply one component. Can you just briefly take us through the other things you do as part of the chain of production that you have kept focused on quality?
Well, go on, Mafail, Benromach, obviously, because just about all of our production goes for bottles of single malt. We had to be very, very careful that we produced the highest quality spirit. And the way we looked at the spirit character of Benromach that we've got is the sum of many parts in the production process, not just one or the other. Yes, some parts contribute far more than others, but we look at it as maybe like a jigsaw puzzle, where you've got some big parts, some medium parts, and some smaller parts. And at the end of the day, all these parts make up the picture. Yeah. Which is the new make character, Benromach. And we feel that all of these contribute, and even if you take out a small part, you're still missing. The picture isn't complete. And that goes right through the production, from the phenol levels in the barley variety. Benromach, we have the sort of more peated version of the traditional Speyside that gives that certain character. The milling, the malting part, also the mashing, where we produce a slightly cloudier wort that gives us the malt nutrients, which gives us a sort of richer full body character for the fermentation. We have long fermentation here at Benromach. We tried long and short. Very quickly we knew that the long fermentation, which is anything up to 5 days, gives us a rich, complex, fruity character. So we quickly went on to the long fermentation. Distillation, we picked the size and shape of stills that we thought would give us a kind of medium to heavy character, which we wanted at Benromach. We have plenty of cooling water here because we have we inherited the amount of water that we got from the previous owners. So we have probably more water than we actually need here, which gives us loads of cooling, which can actually give us less copper reactivity in the distillation process, which allows us to give a little bit more heavy character into the spirit. So you'll see how all these parts are joining together. We also use the finest quality oak casks, fast fill bourbons, fast fill sherry casks. At Benromach, we only use fast fill casks for the maturation of the new make spirit. So as you see, the jigsaw puzzle is all coming to piece together to make that what we call the new make Benromach, and then obviously we have the maturation. And at the end, another part is the environment where we actually mature it. It's another part of the jigsaw puzzle, and this is how it all comes together to make the new make and then also the mature Benromach single malt whiskey.
Well, thanks very much for that, Keith. We're really going to conclude there, my friends, because this is a very useful opportunity. If you ever get a chance to visit a distillery, you have people like Keith, years in the business, who are doing every part, every process, seeing it right through to the finished result, which you and I enjoy in a glass. And at the end of the day, with the price of whiskey, it really does come down in the long term, and we all gain our own experience. It's down to the intrinsic quality of what is in the bottle, whether it be a 10-year-old or a 50-year-old, it makes no difference. And thanks very much, Keith.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you. We'll see you soon for another wee whisky review, possibly something Benromachy. Okay. Wee wave to the camera.